In today's video, I am going to explain anatomy and function of trapezius. Trapezius is right here. This is huge shoulder girdle muscle. See that? And this is right side. Of course, there's trapezius on left side. See, this is humongous muscle. I am going to explain its origin, insertion, function, and important relationship about neck pain and headache. Let me explain origin first. Origin is basically head to thoracic spine. Let's go to detail. First part is right here. This is occiput. Simple, right? Then it goes down, it goes down, it goes down. It basically attaches to cervical spine. But tricky part is muscle fiber is trapezius attaches to connective tissue. Yep, there's connective tissue around cervical spine. There's ligament. This ligament is called nuchal ligament. Nuchal ligament. Muscle fiber or trapezius attaches to nuchal ligament. That means this muscle does not directly attach to cervical spine. That attaches to cervical spine via nuchal ligament. Does it make sense? Then let's go down, 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 down. Trapezius attaches to spinal process of T1 through T12. Spinal process of T1 through T12. That's very wide range, right? T1 is here, T12 is right here. That goes all the way down to end of thoracic spine. That's about it. This is origin of trapezius. Occiput, right here. Nuchal ligament. Do you remember? Muscle fiber does not directly attach to cervical spine. That attaches to cervical spine via nuchal ligament. Then, spinal process of T1 through T12. This is origin. Now, let me explain its insertion. Insertion is about here. Basically, it's scapula. However, trapezius attaches to scapula plus somewhere. This is anterior lateral view. This is trapezius. Let's look at here, this part. This blue part is clavicle. Trapezius attaches to lateral part of clavicle. Lateral part of clavicle. It's about 1/3 of lateral clavicle. Then if you go a little bit lateral, what is this bony bump? This is part of scapula. This part is called acromion. Acromion is flat, kind of broad surface of scapula. Lateral 1/3 of clavicle and acromion. Let's go back to posterior view. This is where acromion is. Plus, trapezius attaches to this part of scapula. This part is called spine of scapula. Spine of scapula. You can easily palpate this part. This is very bony. You can feel that. You can obviously feel that. Well, this is it. Now, let me talk about function of trapezius. Trapezius has numerous functions. First thing first, I need to talk about basic, general function of trapezius. General function for scapula, that is this movement. This is scapular adduction. Scapular adduction is not shoulder adduction. Shoulder adduction is this way, you close armpit. However, scapular adduction is this way. You bring scapula towards thoracic spine. This is general function. Now, you can divide upper fiber. This fiber can do this kind of movement. This is elevation. Elevation plus upward rotation. Upward rotation is you rotate scapula kind of this way, kind of outward. This is upward rotation. This is the function of upper fiber. Of course, the part of upper fiber can do adduction. Okay, this is middle fiber. Middle fiber function is, of course, adduction, because look at orientation of middle fiber. It's pretty much horizon. Yep, when this muscle contracts this way, that does scapular adduction. Let's go to the last part. This is inferior fiber. This fiber is interesting. This can also do upward rotation. Upward rotation is this way. That's a little bit weird, isn't it? However, if you see the insertion part of inferior fiber, that's here. It's kind of medial part of spine of scapula. When inferior part contracts this way, that kind of brings scapula kind of this direction, don't you think? Then this kind of a diagonal direction brings scapula to upward rotation. If inferior fiber attaches to all the way lateral to spinal scapula, that wouldn't do upward rotation. Key thing is inferior fiber attaches to medial part of spine of scapula. This attachment, this physics of movement brings scapula to upward rotation. This is very, very important. Well, this is functional for scapula. If you look carefully, trapezius attaches to occiput, cervical spines, via nuchal ligament, of course, then thoracic spines. This muscle has something to do with spines and head movement. Let me explain that. If you look carefully, trapezius can do so many things for head, neck, and thoracic spines. I want to pick up one movement. If trapezius contracts bilaterally, that means both sides contraction, that brings head and neck to extension. Neck extension. If you look more detailed, trapezius can do so many things. It's like side bend, rotation, maybe that can move thoracic spines, but I want to be as simple as possible. Trapezius function for neck and head, extension, that's it. Trapezius can move scapula plus neck and head, very important thing. One more thing about function of trapezius, that is important for stabilization. This is very important for stabilization of scapula and head, neck, thoracic spine. If the trapezius doesn't work, scapula is not well stabilized. Scapula stabilization is important for shoulder movement. Head, neck stabilization is important to stabilize your posture. That is why trapezius is important for head, neck, scapular stabilization. Now let me explain important relationship of headache and neck pain. This is posterior view. This is trapezius. Plus, I want to explain nervous tissue in this part. You see this part? This is very tiny, it's very thin. But in reality, this is very thick and big nerve. This is greater occipital nerve. This nerve emerges from C2 and it shows up on posterior part of neck and head, and it goes all the way up to parietal area. This nerve is freaking important for neck pain and headache. This nerve is very close to trapezius. Yep, if trapezius gets tight, this tightness may affect for greater occipital nerve. One more muscle. What is this one? This is sternocleid mastoid. Sternocleid mastoid is neck muscle. It is very close to occiput. Then there's space between occiput right here. This is between trapezius and sternocleid mastoid. Greater occipital nerve emerges between this space. Now what happens if your trapezius or sternocleid mastoid gets tight? What happens to this space? This space may be aggravated, may be diminished. Now, what's going to happen for greater occipital nerve? That can have impingement. Nervous tissue hates too much compression nor too much impingement. If nervous tissue is compressed, this can have numbness, pain, dysfunction, of course. That is why tension of trapezius and sternocleid mastoid is very important for neck pain and headache. Tightness around this area can be from multiple reasons. That can be from car accident, that can be from whiplash, that can be from martial arts trauma, sports head trauma. So many various things. Anyway, tightness around occiput area, particularly trapezius and sternocleid mastoid. This tightness aggravates greater occipital nerve. Do you remember? Greater occipital nerve goes all the way up to parietal area. Thus, if you have headache on posterior part, occipital area and top of head, maybe your greater occipital nerve is aggravated. This can be one possibility for neck pain and headache. In today's video, I explained basic anatomy and function of trapezius. I explained its origin, insertion, function, and important relationship with neck pain and headache. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.